Benedict has a computer that is assigned an internet protocol address. The IP address is 198.167.214.0. The IP address is represented as denary values. Convert the denary values 167 and 214 from the IP address to 8-bit binary. So we're going to go through these individually, starting off with 167. To convert this denary number into a binary number, we have this method that I've written at the top right. We're going to be repeating these steps over and over again until we get 0. All right. So the first thing that we have to do is to divide our number by 2. So we're going to say 167 divided by 2. That's going to give us 83. And when we do the division, we want to take the remainder of this division. So the remainder from this is going to be 1. Let's go back to the first step, which is to divide by 2. So we're going to take our number 83, and we're going to divide that number by 2. 83 divided by 2 is 41, with a remainder of 1. Let's now repeat this. So again, divide 41 by 2, and that's going to give us 20, remainder 1. Let's divide 20, and we get 10, remainder 0. Let's take 10 and divide that by 2. And we get 5, remainder 0. Let's take 5, divide that by 2, and we get 2, remainder 1. Let's take 2, divide that by 2. We're now going to get 1 with a remainder of 0. Right, we haven't yet reached 0. Let's do our last division, which is going to be 1 divided by 2. And that now gives us 0, remainder 1. We've now reached 0. And if we continue dividing by 2, we're just going to get remainders of 0. I'll demonstrate this quickly. If we take 0, divide that by 2, we get 0, remainder 0. 0 divided by any number just gives us 0 with 0 remainders. And you can see we get stuck in this loop of repeating zeros. So we're not going to do that. We're going to stop as soon as we reach 0. And our binary number answer can be taken by reading the remainders from the bottom going up. So let's go ahead and write these down. Our answer is going to be 1. Let's bring the 0. Then we have 1. We have 0 and 0. And 1, 1, and 1. And that is our answer. We can fill this out over here. And that is the first part of our solution. We now have to convert the denary number 214 into binary. And we could follow the same method. However, there is a slightly faster method when converting denary numbers into binary. It doesn't matter which one you use in the exam, but whichever one you feel more comfortable with should be the one that you use. I'm going to go through the second method. We're going to start with the letter 1. We're going to now multiply this number by 2. So we'll write down 2 on the left. We'll then multiply this number by 2. So we write 4. And we're going to continue multiplying this number by 2 until we reach a number that is just larger than this denary number. So let's keep going. 1, 2, 4, 16, 32, 64, 128, and 256. You can see that 214 lies between these two values. So we're going to erase the last value, ignore that last value, and we're going to be left with this set of numbers. What we now want to figure out is which of these numbers do we need to make up 214? The idea is that any combination of these numbers can make any number between the range of 0 up to 255, which is one less than the number we erased, 256. So the way that we figure out which numbers are going to be added up to make up 214 is to start on the left-hand side and continuously subtract each number from our denary number 214. Let's start with 214 and we'll subtract 128. 128 goes into 214, so we're going to write a 1 underneath 128. The result of this is going to be 86. And we'll go on to our next value, which is 64. Does 64 go into 86? Yes, it does. So we'll subtract 64 from this value, and we'll place a 1 underneath 64. 86 minus 64 gives us 22, and we'll move on with the next value. 32 does not go into 22, so we're going to write a 0 underneath 32. 16 does go into 22, so we're going to subtract 16 from 22, and we're going to write a 1 underneath 16. The result of this calculation is going to be 6. 8 does not go into 6, so we're going to write 0 underneath 8. 4 does go into 6, so we're going to subtract 4 from 6, and we're going to write a 1 underneath 4. The result of this is going to be 2. 2 does go into 2, so we're going to subtract 2 from 2, and we're going to write a 1 underneath 2. The result of this is now 0. 1 does not go into 0, so we're going to put a 0 underneath the 1. And this is our binary number, 110101110. Let's copy it over. And there we have our second half of the answer.